Why is the world struggling to solve the water crisis when the solution seems so simple?
More water.
More water.
Humanity spends $153.2 billion on water every year, yet by 2030, water demand is expected to exceed supply by 40%, 2.1 billion people still don't have access to safe drinking water, and just a little less of half of our wastewater is dumped to the environment untreated.
That is one big pile of shit.
I've spent the past 4 years interviewing over 200 CEOs or founders and reading far too much World Bank, OECD, UN, NGO or academic reports to forge these two convictions. The problem is much, much, much worse than what you think, but the solutions are at hand if we put our act together. Why is the global water crisis more than just a shortage issue? How does it impact businesses around the world? And will we soon have to ask how close we are to a global economic collapse due to a water crisis? Let's dig in. So I said we spend $153.2 billion a year on water, which may sound like a lot, but it's just a little less than 0.2% of the world's GDP. To put that number in context, here's a riddle for you at home. You know, oil and gas, that thing that we supposedly want to exit, which needs to be faded out, to be reduced, to be...
Yes, come to the point.
Well, how much public money do you think we spend on subsidies for oil and gas? Zero, because why would you subsidize something you'd like to exit? Zero, because when oil and gas companies post record profits, there's no point in subsidizing them. Zero, because you still can't drink oil, or $7 trillion. Can you guess? Well, as crazy as it sounds, oil and gas subsidies indeed reached $7 trillion in 2022, and that's about 50 times more than what we spend on water. But wait, $153.2 billion is already a lot of money. Maybe that's enough. Well, not at all. Just to reach the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal number 6, universal access to safe drinking water and sanitation for all, we would need to spend $140 billion more per year. So if I take a shortcut, we would have to double the world's spending. Still, that's an average. In South-Southern Africa, that means multiplying spending by up to 17 for water, and for the low-income countries, you can see in deep purple on this map, that means multiplying spending by up to 42 times for wastewater. The good news is that we can afford it. According to water.org, the annual coping costs of people not having access to water and wastewater services are estimated to $300 billion. So, if we do quick maths, we will probably prefer spending an additional $140 billion per year and have everyone covered with the human right to water and sanitation, then keep losing $300 billion a year in inevitable diseases, losses of productivity, and death. The problem is that it's not that straightforward.
Yeah, you already said that.
I know, I even said it in a TED talk. Bragging time! But there's news on that front. It comes from the latest World Bank report on the topic, and it's really, really counterintuitive, to say the least. Figure that. If you speak with a water utility almost everywhere around the world, they'll tell you that they are underfunded. And we just saw that, indeed, they are. But meanwhile, those same water utilities don't spend all of their money. Like, not at all. In that report, the World Bank estimates that 28% of the sector's allocated funds go unspent. It's like you need 20 bricks to build a wall, you only get 10, you only use 7, and then everybody's surprised that the wall looks weird. And that's not the end. Over the last decade, water sector public spending also saw a 6% decline in productivity, the cost efficiency of projects went down to 87%, and the median technical efficiency to 63%. So, to continue with my analogy, my 7-brick wall also took longer to build as expected, is made of questionable materials, and 3 of the bricks are misaligned.
That doesn't sound good.
Indeed, that sounds like we're very actively failing at solving today's water challenges. We're progressing at 1/4 of the speed needed to reach our 2030 targets, and you'll be surprised, that's still not the end of it. Because, yeah, what could be worse than not having enough water for everybody to strive? Oh, you're right, we could run out of food too. In the same structural underfunding we're discussing so far, we are also missing $3.5 billion of yearly investments in irrigation, which totally froze the progress towards SDG 2, zero hunger, as no region in the world lowered its hunger and undernourishment rates between 2014 and 2019, food availability per capita declined and vulnerability to food insecurity increased. Remember how the Food and Agriculture Organization estimates that we need to raise overall food production by some 70% by 2050? Well, good luck doing that without water. And I could continue on by telling you how this impacts SDG 1, no poverty, SDG 3, good health, and almost all the others, but you got my message, I guess. The water sector is the embodiment of this famous Chandler Bing quote in Friends.
If I'm going down, I'm taking everybody with me.
Now, in Sustainable Development Goals, there's development. So, does it imply that this is essentially a developing world's problem? Well, let's look at the world's wealthiest countries' infrastructure. The US EPA regularly runs a health check on the country's infrastructure since the 1980s. By then, they estimated that 2% of the infrastructure was in very poor condition, which is concerning because we only replace 0.2-2.5% of our infrastructure every year in the developed world. But come on, 2% is okay-ish, right? Well, by 2020, the same EPA estimated that now 23% of the infrastructure was in very poor condition, and an additional 9% had already elapsed its lifetime. That's just about 32% of the infrastructure that is out of order. No wonder North America loses 119 liters per capita and per day in leaks on the water network. And even if that's gonna hurt my brain, if I'm addressing North America, I probably shall translate that. That's 31.4 gallons of water per person wasted every day, or in even simpler terms, one full bathtub. Every day! In money terms, this means that the backlog cost to just bring back the US infrastructure on track rose from $140.5 billion in 1995 to $345.1 billion in 2015, $473 billion in 2018, and $630 billion in the latest EPA study published last week. Well, I wouldn't be a wise ass if I were you, Europe. I picked on the US because it was the latest of the press. But the situation is not much different in Europe, just a tad more scattered. So, what's the way forward? I believe that what we're learning here is that same old won't work. The public sector is not ready to throw more money at the problem, or at least not to the extent needed. And even if it were, we've seen that the existing players would struggle to absorb that money, so that there would be tremendous efficiency losses between investment and actual action. But the good news is that another path is possible. $86 trillion a year of economic activities depend on water to keep existing, let alone striving. And these companies will not let their businesses fade out just because the water sector can't put its acts together. So they've started investing in mitigating their water risk, and they will continue to do so. If we need proof of that, we can look at CDP's yearly water report as they survey companies to disclose and report their water risk and progresses towards water security. I did that in great detail last year. If you missed it and you're interested, the link is in the description. But in a nutshell for today, over the last 5 years, disclosure rose by 85%, bringing the global investment opportunity from valuing water to $2.3 trillion. CDP looks every year in the mirror, so their numbers are pretty down to earth. But if we look on the horizon, Global Water Intelligence did the exercise to project what will happen in 2034. And their result speaks for itself. They expect that opportunity to rise to $12.6 trillion. So yes, we're failing in water so far. But if we assume that the obstacle is the way, we're not doomed to keep failing as there are solutions at hand. And if we put our acts together, what we call failure today will swiftly become backlog, which in turn will represent a tremendous investment and business opportunity. So let me conclude with this simple projection. The total value of water solutions and technology companies is projected to grow from $219 billion in 2024 to $1.4 trillion in 2034. That's a 17% compound annual growth rate. So if you want to make money while helping those incredible entrepreneurs to do good, you'll want to subscribe to stay up to date, and I'll see you next time.